Hi friends, this is the last lecture or last session of series of lectures on module 3 of the course Engineering Physics with subject code or course code 18PHY12-22. In the previous session, we solved numerical problems on the topics of divergence of a vector field and curl of a vector field. That was numerical problems part 1. Today, we shall solve numerical problems on optical fibers. So, this is numerical problems part 2. And in this particular session, we shall solve numerical problems on the topics numerical aperture, acceptance angle, critical angle, fractional RI change, then the V number and number of modes or modes of propagation, and finally the attenuation of optical energy in the optical fibers. And finally, I will give you some homework problems which you can solve on your own. The first problem states, calculate the numerical aperture and the angle of acceptance for an optical fiber having refractive indices 1.563 and 1.498 for core and cladding respectively. Here the refractive indices of core and cladding are given. So we shall write down the data. So the RI of core is given, which is N1, it is 1.563. RI of cladding is given, N2, it is 1.498. Here, since the surrounding medium is not mentioned, we shall assume that the surrounding medium is air, and hence we assume the value of N0 as 1. So, as per the problem, we need to calculate the numerical aperture and the angle of acceptance. So, we have to calculate NA and θ0. So, numerical aperture is given by this formula 1 over n0 under square root n1 square minus n2 square. We have done the substitution for n1 square and n2 square. Here n0 is equal to 1, therefore you can leave this part, 1 by 1 is 1. So, if we calculate this, we get 0.4460. This is the value of numerical aperture. The acceptance angle is given by sine inverse of the numerical aperture. In other words, we know that numerical aperture is given by sine of the acceptance angle θ0. So, therefore, θ0 is sine inverse of numerical aperture. So, substitute for the numerical aperture and we get this value, that is θ0 is equal to 26.49 degree. And if you convert this into degree and minutes, it is 26 degree 29 minutes is the answer. The second problem states, the refractive indices of core and cladding of a step index optical fiber are 1.45 and 1.4 respectively, and its core diameter is 45 micrometer. Calculate the fractional RI change and the numerical aperture. So, here the RI of refractive indices of core and cladding are given and core diameter is given. We have to calculate the fractional RI change del or delta and numerical aperture NA. Here the core diameter is given and it is a redundant data. We do not use it because it is not required. Fractional RI change is given by the formula. Here delta is equal to N1 minus N2 by N1, and numerical aperture is given by the formula 1 by N0 under square root N1 square minus N2 square. So, in both the cases we do not use the core diameter. It is not required. Therefore, this data is redundant. So, RI of the core 1.45, RI of the cladding 1.4. The value of N0, that is the RI of the surrounding medium, is assumed to be 1 as it is not mentioned. So if it is not mentioned, assume the surrounding medium to be air and take the value of n hat as 1. We need to calculate the fractional or HN delta and numerical aperture. So numerical aperture is given by this formula. Substitute for n1 and n2, we get 1.45 square minus 1.4 square under square root, and it is 0.3775. This is the numerical aperture. Then fractional RI change is given by 1.45 minus 1.4 divided by 1.45. This is 0.0345. So hence the values of numerical aperture and the fractional RI change. The problem number 3 states, calculate numerical aperture and critical angle of a fiber having a core RI 1.5 and cladding RI 1.45. The data that are given, RI of core 1.5, RI of cladding 1.45, assuming the surrounding as air, surrounding medium as air, we take n naught is equal to 1 because the surrounding medium is not mentioned. Unless and until it is mentioned, you can take the value of n naught as 1. If it is mentioned, you have to take the RI of that particular medium. We need to calculate the numerical aperture and critical angle for the core cladding combination. Critical angle for the core cladding combination with the RIs 1.5 and 1.45. Numerical aperture is given by the formula, as you know, 1 by n naught under square root n1 square minus n2 square. If you substitute for n1 and n2 square, take the difference and square root, we get 0.3840. This is the numerical aperture. We know the formula for critical angle for this pair of core and cladding, that is theta c is equal to sine inverse of n2 by n1. So n2 is 1.45 and n1 is 1.5. This ratio turns out to be 0.9667. So take the sine inverse, we get this critical angle as 75.17 degree, and convert this into degree and minutes, and it is 75 degree 10 minutes. The next problem is on the refractive index of core and acceptance angle, and also the fractional index change. The statement of the problem is, an optical fiber has numerical aperture of 0.32. The refractive index of cladding is 1.48. Calculate the refractive index of core, the acceptance angle of the fiber, and the fractional index change. So let us calculate the three quantities. So the data that are given are the numerical aperture and the RI of cladding. So we need to calculate the RI of core using these two data. So numerical aperture 0.32, RI of cladding is 1.48. Again, we shall assume the RI of surrounding medium n0 is equal to 1. So we need to calculate the RI of core, acceptance angle, and fractional index change. So we know the numerical aperture formula. It is 1 over n0 is equal to n1 square minus n2 square. Here in this problem, numerical aperture is given, RI of the cladding is given. So we can rearrange the terms in the formula. So this n1 square has to be separated here. This n1 becomes equal to n2 square plus na square under square root. So if we substitute for n2 and numerical aperture, if we square and add, and if the root is taken, we get 1.514. And the acceptance angle is nothing but sine inverse of numerical aperture. Numerical aperture is 0.32 take the sine inverse, the value that is obtained is 18.66 degree. It could be written as 18 degree 39 minutes. So this N1 value that is obtained could be used to calculate the fractional RI change, N1 minus N2 by N1. So take the difference, N1 minus N2 divided by N1. The value obtained is 0.224. This is the value of fractional index change. See, in this particular chapter, that is optical fibers, numerical problems are very simple, and we are solving different types of problems, and this is one of the types. An optical fiber has a core RI of 1.45 and RI of cladding is 3% less than the core index. Calculate the numerical aperture, angle of acceptance and critical angle. So we need to calculate Na, then theta naught and theta c. Here RI of core is given, that is 1.45, this is N1, RI of cladding is asked. It states that the RI of cladding is 3% less than RI of core. If N1 is the RI of core, less than 3% of N1, right? So N1 minus 3 by 100 into N1. It is N1 into 1 minus 3 by 100, 1 minus 0.03. See, we have the data here, 1.45, 3% less than N1, that is refractive index of cladding, 3% less than the RI of core. So therefore, it is 1.45 minus 3% of 1.45. So we get 1.4065. The surrounding medium is not mentioned, so we can assume N0 is equal to 1. So from this data, we can calculate numerical aperture, acceptance angle and critical angle. Remember the values of the RI of core and RI of cladding. RI of core is 1.45, RI of cladding is 1.4065. So substitute for N1 and N2 in the numerical aperture formula. So as we have done in the previous numericals, so we get 0.3525. This is the numerical aperture. Sine inverse of this value gives the acceptance angle. So sine inverse of 0.3565 is 20.64 degree. Convert this into degrees and minutes, it is 20 degree 38 minutes. Then the critical angle is given by sine inverse of N2 by N1. So it is sine inverse of 1.4065 divided by 1.45. So it is sine inverse of 0.97, we get 75.93 degree, this is 75 degree 55 minutes. So is the answer. Here we have one more type of the problems. The numerical aperture of an optical fiber is given, it is 0.2, when surrounded by air. So the media are mentioned here. When the optical fiber is placed in air, the numerical aperture is 0.2. We have to determine the RI of its core, given the RI of cladding 1.59. Also find the acceptance angle when the fiber is in water of RI 1.33. So the same fiber with the numerical aperture 0.2, if it is placed in water, then what is the acceptance angle? The RI of water is given. So let us do the calculations. Numerical aperture in air, that is given, Na air, that is 0.2. RI of cladding is 1.59, and RI of core has to be more than that. We know RI of core is greater than the RI of cladding. Then it is RI of air, that is the surrounding medium. In the first part, it is N0 is equal to 1. And in the second part of the problem, RI of water is given, that is N water, it is 1.33. So we need to calculate the RI of core N1. See, RI of core and cladding, they don't change, only the numerical aperture and the acceptance angle they change when the fiber is moved from air to water. So we have to calculate the acceptance angle in water, that is theta naught water. So the first part is same as the previous problems. Na numerical aperture is given by this formula. Then n1 is equal to under square root n2 square plus na square. N0 is equal to 1, square on both sides, move na square, n2 square to the LHS, and n1 is equal to under square root, we get this equation. Substitute for n1 and numerical aperture. So if we substitute, we get 1.602. And also, this numerical, the ratio of numerical aperture in air to the numerical aperture in any other medium is equal to the refractive index of the medium. You can remember this formula. We can derive this using this relation. The numerical aperture of the optical fiber is the highest in air. And in the denser medium, the numerical aperture goes on decreasing. So numerical aperture in air divided by numerical aperture in water gives the refractive index of water. So substitute here, numerical aperture in air by water, that is numerical aperture in water is numerical aperture in air divided by refractive index of water 0.2 by 1.33, we get this value. So once we get the numerical aperture in water, we can calculate the acceptance angle in water. It is nothing but sine inverse of numerical aperture in water, which is given by 0.1504, right? So therefore, theta naught in water, that is acceptance angle in water, is 8.649 degree, and it is 8 degree 38 minutes. So this is how we solve such problems. Remember this formula. And remember this point, numerical aperture is maximum in air. So numerical aperture in any medium will be less than the numerical aperture in air. Then this ratio, that is numerical aperture in air divided by numerical aperture in medium, gives the refractive index of that particular medium in which the fiber is placed. The problem number 7 states that the angle of acceptance of an optical fiber is 30 degree when it is placed in air. Find the angle of acceptance when it is in a medium of RI 1.33. This is similar to the problem number 6. In problem number 6, we calculated the numerical aperture. We can use the same formula. We can calculate the numerical aperture of the optical fiber in water. Then numerical aperture can be related to the acceptance angle using the relation. Numerical aperture is equal to sine of the acceptance angle, and we can calculate the acceptance angle in the medium of RI 1.33. Since the RI is 1.33, we can say that the medium is water. So it can be any medium, it need not be water, but here we are taking it to be the water. Acceptance angle in air is 30 degree. RI of water is given, it is 1.33. We have to calculate the acceptance angle. So we use this formula. Numerical aperture in water is equal to numerical aperture in air divided by the RI of water. You know this formula. Numerical aperture is maximum in air, and this divided by numerical aperture in a medium is equal to refractive index of the medium. So we can put this in the on the numerator of the RHS. You can bring this to the denominator. So we get this particular formula. Then this numerical aperture in water is sine theta naught in water. So retaining sine theta naught of water on LHS, sine inverse on the right hand side of sine 30 by 1.33. because the acceptance angle in air is given, it is 30 degree, sine 30 is half divided by 1.33, we get sine inverse of 0.3759 from this particular ratio. So sine inverse of that would be 22.08 degree, and convert this into degree and minutes, it is 22 degree 5 minutes. So you can observe here, acceptance angle in air is 30 degree and acceptance angle in the medium with RI 1.33 is 22 degree 5 minutes. So it has decreased. If the numerical, if the acceptance angle decreases, numerical aperture also decreases. Problem number 8 is on the modes of propagation. So based on the V number and number of modes, we have to calculate numerical aperture, V number and number of modes of an optical fiber given the core diameter 50 micrometer and core and cladding refractive indices 1.41 and 1.4 respectively for a given wavelength of light 820 nanometer. So this is a direct substitution problem. The RI of core is given 1.41, RI of cladding 1.4, RI of the surrounding medium it is 1, it is assumed to be 1 because it's not mentioned here. The diameter of the core is given, it is 50 micrometer, it is 50 into 10 power minus 6 meter. The wavelength of the radiation is given 820 nanometer, so it is mentioned here 820. We have to calculate the numerical aperture, V number and number of modes. So we know the formula, numerical aperture is given by this formula 1 by n naught into under square root n1 square minus n2 square, substitute for RI of the core and RI of the cladding, square, take the difference and square root, we get 0.1676. The formula for V number is pi d by lambda into numerical aperture. So we have calculated the value of numerical aperture, substitute, then pi is 3.142. Then diameter is given 50 into 10 power minus 6. The wavelength of light that is being used is 820 nanometer, that is 820 into 10 power minus 9. So simplify this, calculate the value, it is 32.11. This is the V number. Number of modes is V square by 2. So this N is V square by 2. So square this divided by 2, we get a number, it's a fraction approximated to the nearest whole number. So it is 516 modes. So this particular fiber allows 516 modes. We have another similar problem here. We have to calculate the number of modes of an optical fiber that will transmit using the following data. That number of modes transmitted by the optical fiber for the with a given data, RI of core is 1.5, RI of cladding is 1.48, core radius is 50 micrometer and wavelength is given by lambda is equal to 1 micrometer. So RI of core is given, RI of cladding is given, core radius is given 50 micrometer and the wavelength is given 1 micrometer. So these are the data, RI of core, RI of cladding, assuming N0 is equal to 1, the RI of surrounding medium, radius is given 50 micrometer, we have to calculate the diameter. So diameter is 2R, it is 100 micrometer. Wavelength of the radiation is given, it is 1 micrometer, 1 into 10 power minus 6. So we have to calculate numerical aperture, V number and number of modes. Remember the values, RIs, okay, diameter and then the wavelength. So numerical aperture is 1 by N0 into N1 square minus N2 square under square root. So substitute, we get 0.2441. The V number is given by pi d by lambda into numerical aperture, pi, diameter of the fiber is 100 micrometer, 100 into 10 power minus 6, the wavelength is 1 micrometer, 1 into 10 power minus 6, so into 0.2441, if we calculate we get the value 76.70, this is the V number, square, the number of modes is given by v square by 2, square this and divide this by 2, approximately this is 2941 modes. We need to approximate this value to the nearest whole number. So it is 29.41 mode. So this is the answer. So this problem number 10 is based on the attenuation. We have to calculate the attenuation in the fiber. An optical fiber of 600 meter long has an input power of 120 milliwatt. So we have an optical fiber, its length is given in meter, that is 600 meter, and the input power is 120 milliwatt. If this is the fiber, so this is the launching end and this is the receiving end. At the launching end, that is P in, the input power is 120 milliwatt, 10 power minus 3, milli stands for 10 power minus 3. And the energy that emerges out is 90 milliwatt, that is P out. So we need to calculate the attenuation. The formula for attenuation, you know this. So before that, we shall write what we need to calculate attenuation coefficient. The formula for attenuation coefficient is alpha is equal to minus 10 by L log to base 10 P naught by Pi, that is PO by Pi, decibel per kilometer. PO, it represents the output power, Pi represents the input power, and this negative sign indicates that the optical power goes on decreasing, the output power goes on decreasing as the signal progresses. Now if you substitute for the values, P out, that is output power, is 90 milliwatt, input power is 120, that milli they get cancelled, therefore they are not written, actually milliwatt, these two they get cancelled. So this is 3 by 4, so 0.75, so log to base 10 0.75 is a negative number. That minus and minus, if you multiply, you get the positive number, into 10 by 0.6, you will get 2.08 decibel per kilometer. So the attenuation in this fiber of length per 600 meter is 2.08 decibel per kilometer. Remember, here the substitution for L is done in terms of meter. So in the discussion on optical fibers, I had made it very clear, it is attenuation is considered for a fiber of length L in kilometer. So 600 meter is converted into kilometer, it is 0.6 kilometer, we get 2.08 decibel per kilometer. Problem number 11 states that the attenuation of light in an optical fiber is 3.6 decibel per kilometer. What fraction of its initial intensity remains after 3 kilometer? It is one of the kind of the problems on attenuation. So we have an optical fiber, say of length 3 kilometer. The length of this is 3 kilometer. The input power is P in. The output power is P out. The ratio P out divided by P in has to be calculated, and this gives a fraction, and that is the fraction of initial intensity that remains after 3 kilometers. So let us calculate. The attenuation coefficient alpha is given, it is 3.6 decibel per kilometer. The length of the fiber is given, it is 3 kilometer. We have to calculate the fraction of light which remains after 3 kilometer. That is P naught PO by PI. PI is the input power, PO is the output power. We know the formula for attenuation coefficient, alpha is equal to minus 10 by L log to base 10 PO by PI, that is output power by input power, so many decibel per kilometer. We can simplify this, put this L to the numerator of LHS and this 10 to the denominator. We can write this as minus alpha L by 10, that is equal to log to base 10 PO by PI. Okay. So this could be written as 10 power, this PO by PI could be written as 10 power minus alpha L by 10 as per the theorems of logarithms. So therefore, PO by PI is 10 power minus alpha L by 10, alpha is 3.6, L is 3 meter and divided by 10. So we get 0.0832. So into 100, this is the fraction. This fraction of light means 0.0832 fraction of input power appears at the output, or we can say the output power is 8.32% of input power. If we multiply this with 100, that fraction gets converted into percentage. So 0.0832 into 100 is 8.32, and we get 8.32%. So output power is 8.32% of input power. So these are the three problems homework for you, and these problems are simple, and we have solved similar problems in this session. So make a note of these problems and solve the same on your own. With this, we have come to the end of today's session and also the series of lectures, and I hope all the lectures were informative, and I have conveyed the concepts in a simple way so that you can understand the concepts very easily. With this, I conclude my session. I wish you all the best for your future. Thank you.